Today, Miguel Indurain, the leader of the Tour de France for a week, faces his final test of this year's marathon. If he wins, he'll become only the fourth Spanish rider in history to win the Tour de France in Paris tomorrow. Hello and welcome to Mâcon. Just 57 kilometres in the heat of the day now stand between Miguel Indurain and victory on the Champs-Élysées tomorrow. But the competition will still be extremely fierce. Gianni Bugno in second place, well, to take the lead, he must gain more than 3 seconds a kilometre. There's also another battle, that between third place Claudio Chiappucci and Charlie Motte of France. Motte is just 9 seconds behind the Italian and he'll fight hard now for a place on the podium tomorrow. Well, during this last week of the Tour de France, Miguel Indurain has come to learn the pressures of wearing the race leader's yellow jersey. And last night, outside of his hotel bedroom, after 11 o'clock, they were still queuing for interviews. And that's the time the rider on the eve of such an important time trial really should be in bed. Paul Sherwin, however, had an early interview with the man who today will ride with pride in the yellow jersey of the Tour de France.
Miguel, do you have a lot of confidence for the time trial tomorrow? Because you've already got 3 minutes lead over Bugno.
Yes, it's a good difference, 3 minutes. 3 minutes gives me confidence for the time trial. It will be difficult for the others to catch me. I'm riding really well.
So therefore you feel comfortable with the 3 minutes lead between yourself and Bugno?
Yes, I think it's sufficient. I'm confident. It would be difficult for him to make up that time. Hopefully nothing will happen. A fall, a flat tire, who knows?
And this morning, Miguel Indurain was taking no chances. He was out riding the whole route along with his teammate Pedro Delgado, who a year ago, of course, he was trying to help win the Tour de France. What a difference a year makes. Now Delgado is making sure that Indurain stays safely on the road today. With him too, Abelardo Rondon, when they checked out the circuit. It's a difficult route here in the winelands. It's undulating and it's a very long way, 57 kilometres.
But one of the early starters on the course today was the Soviet winner from yesterday, Vyacheslav Yakimov. And I said yesterday he could ride a good time trial. Well, at every checkpoint he was setting the best time. And by the time he came into the finish, it was the best time thus far. 1 hour, 30 minutes and 34 seconds, the standard to beat today. And just look at this, Paul, the arrival of Jean-Francois Bernard. He's been creeping closer and closer to Yakimov all through the checks, but he's just going to be pipped.
Well, he wanted really to go for this stage victory today, but as he comes over the line there, 1 hour, 13 minutes and 59 seconds. Good enough for second place, but I think the work he's done so far is too good. Now we're back on the road with LeMond here. He went through the first time check in best place when he went through, but now he's just been beaten by 31 seconds by Claudio Chiappucci. LeMond should very soon be coming to the 36-kilometre time check.
So Greg would like to finish this final weekend of the Tour de France on a high spot. He really is trying as hard as he can, but the surprise so far is Claudio Chiappucci, the man who can't ride time trials, going through the 20-kilometre point, knocking Greg LeMond off the number one spot, and gone through there in 26 minutes 35 seconds. Bugno and Indurain still to arrive, but here is the arrival at the first check now of Gianni Bugno. The time to beat 26:35, so Gianni Bugno is also slower than Claudio Chiappucci, and this is turning out to be quite a surprise.
Well, it really is a surprise, because this man Chiappucci, his weak point is supposed to be his time trialing. It may be that he started very quickly, because the last 25 kilometres of this course is very, very difficult. Bugno going through there in second place, just in front of LeMond.
So here is Greg LeMond, and just before the start of the race today, Paul Sherwin was talking with him, and despite his problems in this race, he still seems to remain optimistic.
Well, it's not the same as, say, last year when I was in the yellow jersey. There's a difference when you've got a lot of stuff at stake, I guess. But I'm feeling better. day by day. So I'd like to finish the tour on a good note. And you know, I don't know. It depends how Miguel, Indra, I don't know how tired they really are. But it'd be nice to win a stage. And it's possible.
Well, it may be possible, Greg, but I wonder if you know now what Chiappucci has done at this very check as we watch the arrival of the last rider in the Tour de France at 20 kilometres today, Miguel Indurain, and look at the following entourage behind him. The time to beat Chiappucci's 26:35, Paul, and he's not going to do that.
Well, that's not the important thing for him. The important thing is the time of Gianni Bugno. He may well have paced himself and Chiappucci started very quickly, because I'm sure Miguel Indurain would love to win this time trial, but what's more important is pacing his whole ride on the ride of Gianni Bugno.
And this is the situation after that 20-kilometre check. Chiappucci now has set the fastest time of the day there. Gianni Bugno in second place. Miguel Indurain exactly the same time as Bugno. And if it stays like that, Indurain will be very, very happy indeed.
Definitely. He'll be getting all the information from his team manager. That's the advantage of starting as last man. You know what all the other riders have done.
Well, this is Laurent Fignon. He hasn't set the world alight at 20 kilometres. His time there, 28 minutes and 9 seconds, compared with the 26:35 at Chiappucci. But even so, this has been a great Tour de France for Laurent Fignon. He has re-established himself as one of the top riders here in France. And as we watch here the yellow jersey of Miguel Indurain, this is the situation of 45 kilometres. Indurain a little way before this point yet. Greg LeMond through, 58 minutes 34. Setting the best time ahead of Yekimov, who has already finished with the best time, but it looks now as though Yekimov is going to slip away when Greg LeMond comes up to the finishing line. Enormous crowd here cheering on the race leader in the Tour de France, who went through that 20-kilometre check exactly equal with the rider in second place in the Tour, Gianni Bugno. Well, here's Charlie Motte, and it looks as though he might be losing out at the moment, Paul, with his battle with Claudio Chiappucci. This is the situation at 40 kilometres now. Chiappucci still leading the charge from the back of the field, 52 minutes and 40 seconds. LeMond in second place, but closing in at every check on the gap on Chiappucci, only 15 seconds back now, and Yekimov is at 44 seconds. Still, Bugno and Indurain to arrive at that check. But I can tell you the situation at 36 kilometres where Indurain has arrived. He's leading there with 46 minutes and 22 seconds. Chiappucci 3 seconds slower. Bugno 20 seconds slower. And LeMond half a minute slower. But the surprise is at the moment, Paul, that Motte is not going to claim third place in the Tour. Sorry, Paul, but this is the arrival of Greg LeMond coming in here. And it's going to be the best time. So Greg LeMond is fighting back to lead the Tour de France, with possibly a stage victory here as he comes down towards the finish. And the crowd now cheering Greg LeMond all the way down the home straight. This is a rider who refused to give up the Tour de France, and instead he has fought back the hard way. He comes home now with what will be the best time. Listen to the crowd, they still love him. As Greg LeMond crosses the line, 1:12:33. Greg LeMond has the best time. Now what can the others do? And we will take a very quick break.
The Tour heads into Paris tomorrow for what amounts to a lap of honour for those riders who've lasted the pace, and among them will be ATTOR rookie Lawrence Roche. Now, before the race started, there was a certain amount of talk about Lawrence being on the Tour because of his brother Stephen rather than on merit. Well, he's proved a point by finishing, and in fact, he's looked stronger and more confident as the race has gone on. The last time we checked on Lawrence, he said the only stage he really still feared was that to Alpe d'Huez. But in fact, he finished the climb looking confident and well inside the time limit. With most of the hard work over, I spoke to Lawrence after Thursday's stage to Aix-les-Bains and asked him if he'd ever experienced a race like the Tour.
Never, nothing like it. It's a great feeling to be with the Tour. Like, you know, the people and getting up like that hill today, up the Rover. I rode up it 3 weeks ago and there was no one on it, and it felt as long as 20 kilometres, and it was as long. It went on for hours, and today we rode up it was no bother. It's amazing the difference, like the atmosphere, it gives you goose pimples and everything, it's great.
During the first week of the Tour, though, it was anything but great for Lawrence. First, he lost the guidance of his older brother Stephen, eliminated in the team time trial. Then, his worst day on the Tour's longest stage, coming into Reims just ahead of the broom wagon after crashing. But you seemed up even after that. We spoke to you when you came across the finish. You never seemed to lose your optimism.
That might be being a roach, like maybe that's in, it's in the blood, maybe.